Now, just when we needed it the most, my darlings, David Hoyle, the fireball of avant-garde cabaret, arrives at Foyle Pride. Up Foyle Pride! His new show is packed full of wit, wisdom, and humanity. David is the original performance avalanche, an all-singing, all-raging, bona fide performance legend. He has appeared in his own Channel 4 TV series, appeared in films and on stages worldwide and across the universe. He was the winner of the Icon and Originality QX Awards of 2019. Please put your hearts and souls and hands together for David Hoyle.
Beautiful. Wasn't that lovely? Wasn't that nice? Ave fucking Maria. So many of us still living with guilt and shame. No wonder a lot of us take to the bottle, and indeed are no strangers to intravenous drug use. Ave fucking Maria. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and those of us clever enough to have transcended gender. We're all here, we're all alive, although actually there were a few corpses at the top end of the bar. Flies round the eyes, worms coming out of the mouths. Leave them! We need to be aware of our own mortality. Ave Maria. What we need to do, all of us collectively, is take naturally derived hallucinogenic drugs. ASAP. If there's anybody in the auditorium tonight who's particularly, shall we say, defensive about how they see themselves, I'm happy for you. I believe in reincarnation, and you will come back as a slug. And although the song thrush community is very threatened, you will be swallowed and shat out so quickly. We're here for 2 fucking seconds on this planet. And if all you can do is, oh, I must be seen as this. I'm very fortunate because I know that each and every one of you in the auditorium tonight has their own gender, has their own sexuality, and I celebrate that. Well done. I love you. It's an honor to perform in your presence. Thank you. You are who you believe you are, and that should be honored to the last breath that you take. Whoever you think you are, as far as I'm concerned, that's who you are. And things are very flexible at the moment. We've got a cost of living crisis going on. We've got the gas and the electricity costing more and more and more. People are paying more and more in rent. And when it comes to identity politics, just get a gun and shoot the cunts. I haven't got a lot of time to waste, but I will say this. Kill all in authority. What we're allowing to happen, all of us collectively, in the me included, is outrageous. All of the politicians, particularly in the UK and Ireland, who believe in the free market, should be frog marched to a local square and put to death. It's as simple as that. Oh, the free market's so marvellous, it's self-regulating, and we believe in small government. I don't. I believe in healthcare, education, and housing. And if you want to make money out of either of those three, then you must go head first into a wood chipper. It's evil, it's immoral. Don't be worrying about what I might or might not do with my anus. Although speaking as a 60-year-old, any offers gratefully received. And my current chat-up line is, "Hi, my name is David. I wear quite a sizable partial denture, which I have to stick in when I get up in the morning or mid-afternoon. If any of you have got any spare money, then please invest in Fixodent. You're going to make a fucking fortune. I'm no stranger to either anxiety or depression or suicidal thoughts, and I've got atrophy of the optic nerves in both eyes. Would you like to have a relationship?" I'm going to leave that with you. I've got a cordless mic, and that means that I can wander amongst you. Remember that all of us, at this moment in time, the whole of our lives have been leading up to this moment. There are no accidents. And the reason that we're all here today, this evening, is about empowerment and mutual support. And we are the fighters, and we will kill all in authority. I'm hoping I've got lung cancer. Because if they say, "Oh, David, you've only got 6 months to live," that gives me 6 months to try and find out where I can get an AK-47. If I'm going, I'm going to take people with me. But nobody in the auditorium tonight. I celebrate the fact that you were born. And I know that some of you will have an internal voice that subverts you, that tells you negative things about yourself. I know. And the reason that we're doing this tonight is to dispel that voice. And after tonight, that voice will be banished from your consciousness. That's all I can do. That's as much as I can do. You're looking amazing. You've got your psychedelic top on. You're looking lovely. What's your name?
Breach.
Breach is with us tonight. Well, we celebrate that, Breach. In the words of Her Late Majesty, have you travelled far? Where have you come from?
I've come from the bog side.
From the bog side. How lovely. I mean, I live in Manchester, you know, in a vermin-infested flat. When you say bogside, I mean, is it literally boggy or... I mean, do you have to put your Wellingtons on to go shopping? Okay. What sort of accommodation do you live in? A tent or...? Just yeah? I know, it's not been easy for you, has it? Can I just say, I'm very sensitive, and a lot of you, the ones that are laughing the hardest, I know that that's not always been the case. Okay. I'm either a deeply gifted spiritual psychic, or I have indeed got paranoid schizophrenia. But I look at you, I can almost tell what your names are, what's gone on in your life. A lot of you have been let down, and I think that's why you're here tonight. Because hasn't it been wonderful with Abby, with George, with Jerry? And you know what's been absolutely marvellous? All of us absolutely love and adore each aunt, every one of you in the auditorium tonight. Because you are the future. I'm going to leave it there. Lovely to see you, Catriona. How's it going?
All good, all good.
Lovely. And we were talking about a united Ireland, weren't we? Okay. But perhaps sort of sweep that under the carpet. But it's so lovely to see you this evening. Okay. I'm getting Germany.
I've been.
You've been, yeah. I just got a German vibe, you know. But I think I picked up on a little bit of bratwurst on your breath. Where was it that you were in Germany? Was it Bremen?
Frankfurt.
Frankfurt. And that will be the Frankfurter. Okay. You see how it works. You see how we're rolling. It's lovely to see you. Okay. Now, don't hide. Don't put your light under a bushel. Okay. These people seem to be quite happy that you sort of kept down, you know. Is this sort of some sort of BDSM relationship you're having? What's your name? Sonia. Sonia is with us tonight. It's lovely to see you, Sonia. And where, you know, I mean, it doesn't matter, but where have you come from geographically?
Poland.
Oh, okay. Well, that's resonating with one or two people in the audience. Doesn't mean a hell of a lot to me, but I just want your friends to look after you. You know, when I looked at you, it was like I was looking at a Labrador in a dog basket. Okay. Have you had a Labrador in your life? There's always a first time. Okay. Everything along... Yeah, all these people are drinkers. You're right. Absolutely. Seek oblivion, because reality is disgusting. It's scary. We've got no stability, no security. And we need a drink, don't we, love? It's great to see you here looking absolutely magnificent. Yes. What is your name, my love?
Jennifer.
Jennifer is with us tonight. Hooray! Jennifer, do you think that you'll go into politics? Because I think you should.
Only if I can join NUM, love.
The NUM? Is that the National Union of Mine Workers? Okay. Are you into mining? Into art? Well, look. Everybody's welcome at my shows. And I pride myself on being completely non-judgmental. Okay. It's lovely to see you. Are you a farmer? You've got a lovely hat on. Yeah. Are you a farmer? Okay. What do you grow? Gherkins, tomatoes. You see how I hit on? I knew. Because you have very fecund fingers, don't you? And do you sell on your produce? But something's telling me that you sometimes give the gherkins and the tomatoes to people who can't afford them. Okay. Well, maybe it's going to happen in the future. Can I just say, I don't want to embarrass you, obviously, but those of us of a certain age, and I've got a light day makeup on today, and I know that I look prepubescent, but some of us remember your lovely work, Hoofdy, and... It's an absolute honour and privilege to be in your presence and to perform in your presence this evening. And I just want to say a massive public, well done. One of the first dissenting voices allowed on national television is with us this evening. And like myself, believes the world of television to be full of backstabbing, money-obsessed pieces of shit who would be better off dead. Okay. Now, here you will see a primed canvas. And later on this evening, I will be immortalizing one of you beautiful people. I'll be guided by spirits as to who it is who's going to be immortalized. Before I do this painting, I'm going to ask you at this stage for words. I just need 7 words. I'm going to paint them on the canvas. And I want you to allow a word to form in your mind. Now, I'm giving you time. Just a word, that's all I'm after. Okay. And I shall take different sections. Over here, have we got a word? Yeah. What word would it be?
Sneezy.
I'll mentally put it in pencil. Over here.
Welcome to the center of the universe.
Welcome to the... Well, that's more than one word, isn't it? But it's very beautiful. Welcome to the center of the universe. And that's where we are here tonight. This is the center of the universe. Let there be no doubt. Welcome to the center of the universe. That's beautiful. Okay, I've got that. What's your name, my darling? You're very charismatic. Francis is with us this evening. And we all celebrate that, Francis. And please remain confident, strong, and beautiful, and diligent, and all the things that you are. It, again, like with Hoofty, it's an honor to perform in your presence. And I celebrate your existence. Okay. So we've got welcome to the center of the universe. More than one word. I'm just looking. A word over here. Have you got a word? Go on, love. You can do it. Chicken. Chicken dippers. Cheeky. Okay. Okay, we can go with that. What's your name? Ethna? Oh, wow, lovely. Yeah. Some of my spelling will be phonetic. Over here, I think there's a word forming. Yeah. Okay. Mycelium. Now then, shall we, yeah. Is it something to do with mushrooms? No. Is it mycelium? Is it the roots of the mushroom? Yeah, the roots of the mushrooms, they meet up, don't they? And they create all the, and they can go on for miles. Well, you know that I'm part of the Red Umbrella. I'm wearing this top, which was a gift from the beautiful sex workers of Dublin to me. No bad whores, only bad laws. That's what it says. And it's an honor to wear this garment this evening. And I'm very happy to say that the Red Umbrella people in Dublin, they're going to curate their own film festival, and that's going to be absolutely amazing. Beautiful people, obviously very open-minded, very into the arts and all the rest of it. There was a time when actors, actresses, performers, and all the rest of it were put in the same category as sex workers. We look into the Roman Empire, don't we? Even a gladiator, even those with them buff bodies, they look like they were muscle Marys, been to the gym, I think a lot of them go to the gym because they don't like reading. But a lot of these gladiators were actually seen as being at the lowest rung of society because they were drawing attention to themselves. Okay, which is pretty much what I'm doing now this minute, you know. Hello, you're very provocative. I will put that word in about the mushrooms. What's your name? What's that?
Aaron.
Aaron. You've gone a bit shy, Aaron. I mean, you strike me as somebody who's probably no stranger to the gymnasium. The Do you not like reading? You like reading as well as going to the gym? Okay. So you've got a lot to offer, haven't you? What's that? The best of both worlds. Is that what you're promising me? Now, have you come out with your mum and your grandma? There's no shame in it. There's no shame in being a grandma, for fuck's sake. How do I spell mycelium? Yeah. M-I, yeah, I've got M-Y so far. C-E-L-I. Okay. It's a very powerful word. We've got that. Now, look. It's Aaron, isn't it? I don't want to leave you with any complexes. Have you... What's that? Has he got a lot of complexes? Okay. Well, if I can do anything to relieve any tension or anything like... how old are you? 24. Isn't it lovely, that? I was once talking to Jerry, and Jerry remembers going into the George in Dublin. Yeah, which we love. And an older gentleman was in conversation with Jerry, and Jerry wasn't in the mood to make love that particular evening. And this older person said, Aaron, this is honest to God's truth, feeling that they'd been slighted, that Jerry wasn't attracted to them because of the age. And it wasn't about that. Jerry was tired. The older man said to him, there was a time when I was younger than all of these cunts. I'm just going to throw that out there and share it with the group, you know. It might be you that gets immortalised on the canvas, but something's telling me that canvas isn't big enough. It's just a feeling that I have, Aaron. You know, you've got a lovely confidence about you. What do you get up to in real life when you're not at subversive cabaret events like this? Are we a member of the circus? No, enjoys going to the circus. What do you do? You play the piano? Isn't that lovely? Wow, I can imagine you tickling the ivories. What sort of music do you enjoy? All sorts. Have you got quite an eclectic taste? Okay. I'm not being funny. I mean, I shouldn't have favourites. But I do find you very provoking. Okay, I need a few more words. Anybody, come on, just shout. What's that?
Passion.
Passion, yeah, we like that. Okay, just let me write passion to start with. We're nearly there. Okay, love that. Another word. Oh, hang on. Did somebody say nemesis? Crevices. Okay. You're too young to know about crevices. Okay, I've got room for one more. Transcendence, who said that? That is a lovely word, isn't it? What's your name, my darling? I quite like that, it's very avant. Okay, oh, I love that. What's your name?
Darren.
How lovely, lovely to see you, Darren. Transcendence, okay, we're gonna go with that. Wasn't Darren lovely? I mean, if things don't work out with Aaron, I've got... Did you say transcendent? Yeah, okay. I'm spelling it phonetically now. Great. Okay, total fucking silence now, please. From the beautiful Jessica. Is that right? Francis, I do apologise. Welcome to the centre of the universe. We're cheeky. You better believe it, we're cheeky. And any politician who lies to us, who takes money from big corporations, we will put to death. We will put to death because we're cheeky. My cell, was it? Something to do with mushrooms. I said earlier on, the whole of humanity at the same time needs to take a natural hallucinogen. And let's find out in the morning whether we'll put up with the politicians or the so-called faith leaders, or maybe they'll be in a heap burning away. Passion, we've all got passion. Sometimes we need a few drinks. Sometimes we need a couple of lines. But we've passion, passion. And tonight, in this glorious venue, the place reeks of passion. That's you. Crevices suggested by someone with a very smooth face. Crevices said to someone who's got a face that looks like a map. Oh yes, I know how to apply makeup. I know how to make myself look young. Crevices are places you can put things, hide things, fill those crevices with love. Transcendent, I think suggested by Darren. Transcendent. All of us here are now in a state of transcendence, because all of our lives has been leading up to this moment. There are no accidents. We're all here for a reason. The world is going to hell, and we in the auditorium tonight are gonna sort it out. Sort it out. Beautiful. Beautiful. So whoever is immortalized this evening will have those very powerful words etched at the back of their portrait. Total fucking silence now, please. I heard a conversation going on over there. I don't know what it was about, and in a way, I don't want to know. Okay. Total fucking silence. I'd now like to do some avant-garde shapes. I'm very into ornithology, and that's the study of birds. You have got to guess, and I'm going to start with songbirds. You've got to guess what songbird it is that I'm embodying through the avant-garde shape that my body will assume. Okay. Demands a lot of concentration. You have to get it right, because when it comes to species, one wouldn't wish to get it mixed up and insult one of the species. Total concentration. As a member of the songbird community, I've got to really concentrate now. It was, of course, the wren. I thought, let's start it off easy. Now I'd like to advance into the world of mammals that are available locally. Have you ever heard of a fox? I thought it was a giveaway, that one. We're going to do one more. Where should we take it now? Do you want to be more international? Shall we go to the plains of Africa? Okay. Big game. Country. Okay. I was thinking of giraffe, but I decided to represent a leopard. And it obviously went above a lot of your heads. I'm now going to sing a song, whether you like it or not, unaccompanied. We were hoping that the BBC Northern Irish Symphony Orchestra were going to show up this evening, but a lot of them are actually intravenous drug users. On a Friday night, what they like to do is jack up and then they form a circle and they all masturbate. Okay. Is this ringing a bell with you? Okay. I'm just trying to inspire you. Can I touch you? No, you have to be careful these days. You can be sued. You've only got to brush up against somebody. And before you know where you are, they're dragging you through the courts. One day, I will immortalise you, Aaron. You know, I need to do this artwork for the Northern Irish Museum of Contemporary Art, you know. I'm not saying it will be a photographic representation, but I can guarantee that you'll have two eyes, a nose and a mouth. And whatever else you're prepared to show me. Okay. Over this way, lovely people. I'm getting a really nice energy. Are you in the show business yourself? No. Is it something that would interest you? I see you performing. Yeah, maybe on film. Let's leave it there. I'm not being funny, but have you ever thought of OnlyFans? No, your mother, I know. It's difficult, isn't it, if you're on OnlyFans to try and sell it to your mother, but if you just occasionally bought her a bunch of flowers or something like that and said, look, I am earning good money. Do you have a difficult relationship with your mother? But it sounds to me like she's holding you back a little bit. Because I picked up on that vibe. Because it resonates with me, you know. A lot of people that are involved in anarchy, death and destruction, actually have come from very so-called respectable backgrounds. That's why I'm walking around in a pair of hold-ups and a very provocative top. Now, I heard this table speaking whilst I was speaking earlier on. And, oh yes, and I'm intrigued as to what it was you were talking about. You're lovely, by the way. You could make a fortune. I mean, you're like the boy next door, aren't you? But you've got a little extra. Okay, what's your name?
George.
George is with us tonight. How lovely. And where did the name George come from? Were your family perhaps fans of the Hanoverian royal family?
I'm not sure, actually, maybe. He's from Carrick. Maybe.
Where's he from?
Carrick.
From Carrick, okay. Carrick. And what's it like in Carrick Fergus?
Not that exciting.
Okay. But I bet you try to make it exciting, don't you, George? You've got a very naughty twinkle about you, you know. If any of you have been, you know, in trouble of any kind with the police, I like you even more. Because a lot of it, you'll have been framed, and nobody, the lady over there, a lot of people don't believe that you hadn't done anything. You were set up, weren't you? You were framed by the police. And then it's difficult saying, no, I didn't do it, because nobody believed you. Well, I believe you. And everybody in the auditorium tonight believes you. Okay. But sometimes when it comes to murder or maiming, sometimes that person, the victim, was actually quite irritating. It's lovely to be here. In the back corner. You probably thought you could hide at the back. Well, you can't. It's lovely to see you. You're looking beautiful. Yeah. And your top that you've got on. Yeah, very, very nice. What was that designer called? I think a family pushed her down the stairs. Laura Ashley. We've got shades of Laura Ashley, haven't it? You're looking lovely. You look a little bit like Denise Welsh. You look like you could be on Loose Women. Okay. What's your name?
Conrad.
Conrad is with us tonight. It's lovely to see you, Conrad. Do you work in a university?
No.
Okay. Have you been to university?
Yes.
Yeah. I got a university vibe from you. Okay. Can you tell us what you're actually up to at the moment?
What do I do? Yeah.
Wonderful. You see, I got the education, didn't I? What subject are you imparting? English is a foreign language. You're very skillful. It's an honour to have you here in the auditorium this evening, and I wish you all the very best with your work. Isn't he wonderful? Look after him. Okay. Okay. I'd like to have one-on-one conversation with all of you to empower you, to tell you that you're not wrong. I don't want anybody here to have any negative feelings about themselves whatsoever. And I'm dedicating this to Hufti, a lovely lady here. Keep getting your name wrong. Francis, of course, Francis. You made me love you. I didn't want to do it. Sing along. I didn't want to do it. You made me love you. And all the time you knew it. I guess you always knew it. You made me happy. Sometimes you made me sad. But there were times, dear, you made me feel so bad. You made me sigh full. I didn't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you. I want some love. That's true. Yes, I do. Deed, I do. You know I do. Give me, give me, give me, give me what I cry for. You know you've got the kind of kisses that I die for. You know you made me. You know you made me. You know you made me love you. Wow. Beautiful. Beautiful. Is there any subject that you think should be brought up on a night of cabaret and we can do a group therapy type of situation? Transgender children are all welcome here in this bar. They are the future. The idea that you can only be one thing or another is anathema to me. I see you all, and I believe that all of you have your own gender. Okay, I'm going to leave that with you, Aaron. Think about it. That's lovely. Again, I'm very drawn to you. You've travelled to Germany. Where else have you been?
Oh, I went all around the world.
You've been all over the world. Something, and your name again? Siobhan is with us this evening. That is wonderful, Siobhan. So you've done Germany. Siobhan does Germany. Where else have you done?
South Africa.
Do you know, South Africa, if I'll never be able to afford this. I'm hoping to have a week in Benidorm. I mean, you're very welcome to join me. Have you come with your mother? No, have you brought your mum tonight? Okay. Yeah, are you Aaron's mother? Lovely. Would you mind if we went to Benidorm? I've got a soft spot for Benidorm, Aaron, because I'm probably one of the few people in the auditorium tonight that went as a 9-year-old to Benidorm when Franco was in control. And I thought, what an interesting thing to do, to send a 9-year-old to a fascist dictatorship. And that's why I've been an anti-fascist pioneer ever since. But South Africa, if I had the money, I'd like to go to Namibia for some reason. Is it Windhoek, the capital of Namibia? I think so. Also, I love the writing of Alexandra Fuller, who was actually brought up in the old Rhodesia before it became Zimbabwe, during the time of the guerrilla war. And so her writing is very, very interesting. The name Alexandra Fuller. So check out all her books. They are absolutely amazing. South Africa, how long were you there?
3 months.
That's a long time. And what did you do whilst you were there?
I lived in a township and I was teaching kids. I was doing music.
Isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing? In a township. And I mean, sometimes you see them on the television, don't you? And it's all corrugated iron and cardboard and this sort of thing. And is that where you were staying? And you had a little room at the back of the school. And is that where you slept? Yeah, yeah. Well, I was interviewed earlier today by Radio Foyle at the BBC. And I said to the gentleman, I think he was called Mark, who was interviewing me, I'd like to live in this studio. All I need is a camp bed, a screen, and a bucket. And it sounds to me like that's probably all you had. But what a wonderful thing to do. Siobhan, isn't it? Yeah. Can we celebrate the life of Siobhan? I knew there was something about you. And I think a lot of the people that are honoured in our society shouldn't be. Because I don't know what you think, but I personally believe that we're living in the age of narcissism / mediocrity. And you're a wonderful person. Okay. Right, I've probably got to hurry things along because there will be a disco happening after the cabaret. So who is now going to be immortalized? We've chosen some lovely music. I will be now guided by spirits as to who is going to be immortalized. I'm being told to go this way. Okay. Somebody over here. And this will hang in the Northern Ireland Museum of Contemporary Art. Okay, it has to be you. Yeah. It has to be you. Looking amazing. Looking so lovely this evening. Beautiful. I'll get you a seat. I'll make you comfortable, you know. Okay, so if you just position yourself there, make yourself comfortable. Tell us a little bit about yourself. What's your name?
I have two. Magnus and Agnes.
Magnus and Agnes. Isn't that lovely? Good for you. Good for you. Magnus or Agnes, it's wonderful to be multifaceted, isn't it? And why limit yourself to just one identity? This is so ridiculous. Oh, I've only got one identity. That's how authentic I am. No, that's how fucking boring you are. We all need to use our brains, use our minds, use our imaginations. And you obviously have Magnus stroke Agnes. And you're looking lovely this evening. I would imagine you're no stranger to show business.
Well, last night I did have my first foray into the wonderful playhouse we have in Derry in the Pride Monologues.
Isn't that fabulous? Well done. That must have been amazing. And how did it go?
It went just fantastically. Everybody performed so well.
Beautiful, beautiful. Well, you know what? I haven't really looked after myself in life, Magnus, you know. No stranger to the world of drink and drugs. But I feel that if I was to die tonight, the entertainment would be very safe in your hands, you know. With an anarchic twist, I'm hoping. I mean, I don't want to, and I'm being serious now, I don't tonight here, of all places, want to be immortalizing and doing the portrait of somebody who's even remotely conservative.
I'm an anarcho-syndicalist.
There you go. I think that's why I was drawn to you, you know. Now, do we have some music suitable for the immortalization of Magnus Stroke Agnes? Oh, what a lovely choice.
Just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true.
I need you, baby. Sangre tan solo un tiro, ¿quién lo disparó? En el Copa, Copacabana, famoso lugar de La Habana. En el Copa, Copacabana, música, baile, pasiones de moda. En el Copa, perdió su amor.
Thanks, Jerry. That's lovely. Beautiful. Thank you. And can we please have a round of applause for Jerry for all that they've done this evening? Absolutely amazing. In fact, let's hear it for everybody who works at this amazing political hotbed, which is loved and respected internationally. All the bar staff. Any security that may be needed. Also, you, my darling, thank you so much for tonight. Okay. And I'm hoping, Magnus, that you can see yourself in this artwork. You know, obviously, once it's dried, you know, it's for you. You can have it. Thank you very much for being my muse and my inspiration this evening. Magnus stroke Agnes. And I wish you all the very best with your career. You're going to go far. Okay. And I'm so happy to meet a fellow anarchist. Because what are we going to do? We're going to kill all in.
Well, we're going to plant loads of trees first. We're all going to read loads of books. And we're all going to make love.
Hooray! Thank you so much. That is beautiful. Beautiful. Thank you. Okay. It's yours when it's dried. Marvellous. Magnus Agnes. I only really know... I want to say a massive thank you to Shah for engaging me. And bringing me over to this most special part of the world. Absolutely. And one day justice will be done. Okay. I only really know two songs all the way through. Here's the second one. It's from a lovely film starring Liza Minnelli. You might know it. Do sing along. And I obviously dedicate it to Aaron. Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. He will hold me fast. I'll be home at last. Not a loser, Francis, anymore. Like the Siobhan, like the last time and the time before. Everybody loves a winner, so nobody loves me. Lady peaceful, lady happy, that's what I long to be. Well, all the odds are there in my favor. Something's bound to begin. It's gonna happen, happen sometime. Maybe this time. Maybe this time. Thank you very much. And on the subject of winning, before I depart in peace and go and serve the forces of anarchy, I'd like us to meet Katrina McHugh, MBE, founder of Open Clasp Theatre Company, who's changing the world one play at a time. You've had work performed in New York, LA, and you are promoting social change on a global scale. Instead of listening or living near London's West End, it's the West End of Newcastle that captured this particular playwright's heart. And so therefore, it gives me great pleasure to award Trina and Tricia, who've been friends for 40 years, very strong queer women. Yeah, Tricia is from beautiful Derry, but moved to Manchester when she was about 16/17. We go back a long way, don't we, my love? And has been there since. Tricia works with the Women's Homeless Unit for over 30 years. Amazing. And you've helped the most vulnerable women in Manchester. Now, as you know, I live in Manchester, as does Jerry, and both of us live in vermin-infested Jerry's council, I'm housing association, so I'm just a little bit posher than Jerry. But both of you are very kind, caring people. And Shah wanted you to have these containers, which I think, is it for a bus pass? Yes. And you can have that. Well done. Congratulations. You deserve it. And that was an honour to award those two very remarkable people with a lovely container for your bus passes. Can I just say, it's been an honour and a privilege to stand on this stage, more so to walk amongst you, and I know that everybody in the auditorium tonight is equally beautiful, equally valid, and equally justified. And every one of you is the future. Thank you very much. I love you. Thank you. I love you. Thank you so much. Love you. Love you, Hufton. Okay. Love you. Thank you.